Hi, I'm Gabriel, and this is Learning English Path. And in this lesson, I'm going to teach you some quiz shows that you can watch to learn English. All right, this is a fun one. Quiz shows to learn English, all right? And I've got 7 for you here. Some of them are American, some of them are British. And the first one here is called Countdown. And that is a British quiz show. And it's all about spelling words with letters. So for each of these shows, I've brought up the YouTube search. So if I click here, then let's open in a new tab and we take a look at, no thanks, we don't want that. Turn on the sound and we have this show. It's a letters and numbers game. So let's click it to this one. You can select vowels and consonants. And then you need to make words using all the letters you have here, right? So the longer the word you can make, let's turn it down. The longer the word you can make, the more points you get, all right? So the object of the game is now, they've got 30 seconds to try to make words out of these letters. And what is this game good for? It's good for spelling, and it's good for vocabulary. You can learn a lot of new words by watching this TV show. Because now, you see, they're going to give their answers after this.
J-A-M-A-S-T-E.
And Game Star. Okay, how appropriate for this video. Gamester. So this is a person who likes to play a lot of games. They are a gamester, right? So this is the kind of interesting word that you can learn if you watch this TV show. And there are so many episodes of this on YouTube that you can browse through. So see how many words you can learn just by watching all of these countdown episodes. All right, the next one I've got for you is Wheel of Fortune. And this is a classic American game show, all right? And it's kind of similar in a way to Countdown in that the contestants are calling out letters. And what they're trying to do is they're trying to complete the phrase or the sentence or the expression, right? So here, if I click here, so get rid of the ad. Ah, mind over matter. So you see, when you know what the expression is, they call it out. So have you ever played the game Hangman? Right? Hangman is just like that. You have a phrase or an expression, and then you need to call out letters. And when you've got the right letter in the phrase, you slowly, gradually build up what the word is, right? So that is Wheel of Fortune. And you can learn a lot of new expressions, a lot of sentences this way. And of course, again, improve your spelling. And let's go to the next one. This is a fun one. It's Catchphrase. This is a British TV show, and this is fantastic for learning idioms. All right, so they show a short video of some very short cartoon, and it represents some kind of idiom or expression or common phrase, right? So let's look at this, an example of the video, right? So, okay, so what is the phrase here? What is happening? You have to guess what the expression is. Okay, Rain on My Parade. You can see that there, right? Rain on My Parade. Because they were having a parade and it was raining. So it's a cute little cartoon that represents the idiom. So this is a fantastic show to learn new idioms with. And the thing is about these shows, it's fun as well. And after a while, you start to get good at them. And that's when you know that your English is improving. All right, the next one is Take Your Pick. So now, the first three were all kind of learning vocabulary and expressions. But now we're on to building your English fluency up a little bit more, right? So this game show is where a person gets asked questions for 1 minute, but they're not allowed to say yes or no in the whole time. They're not allowed to say yes or no. And I used to play this game with my students all the time because it's great for learning how to use full sentences. If you really want to use full sentences and improve your grammar, try answering questions that are yes or no questions, but without saying yes or no. Okay, so let's have a look at how this is done. Yes, no game. Okay. Well, she did not do very well because... he asked her one question and immediately she said yes. So of course, she did not win that game. Do you think you could go 1 minute without saying yes or no? Have a try. Watch this TV show and you'll learn a lot of sentences and how to answer questions. Call My Bluff. This is an old British TV show where you have three people and one word. The word is something that most people would not understand, right? Most native English language speakers will not know the meaning of this word. And the three people have to each give a fake definition. It's either fake or it's the real definition. One of them is explaining the correct definition of the word, and two of them are giving a fake description, so something that is not real. And then the guessers, there are also people who have to guess, who listen to all three definitions and guess which one is the correct definition. Right, let's have a quick look if we can. So I believe the word here, here we go. The word here is...
Hello, this is Hired at No Expense at All.
Let's see, here it is, finally. Zobo, right? Zobo. And then that's when...
The Royal Flying Corps used to call it a Zobo.
He has to give a fake definition, and then the next person after that will give a fake definition. In the end, the guessers will guess which definition is correct, and if they're right, then they win. And so why is this good for learning English? Well, the explanations and the definitions are good. It's not just the new words, because the words that they're talking about in this TV show are very complicated words that will not be used in everyday language, right? They are uncommon. But the explanations and your listening to the definitions, this is what makes this show interesting and worthwhile. The next one is What's My Line? This is an old American TV show, and it's a game where, by the way, it's got its own YouTube channel, which is cool, right? So you have lots and lots of episodes here. It's a game where they have to try to guess what someone's real job is. So they ask a person lots of questions, and the person with the strange job has to answer those questions. And so what you're doing is you're listening to all of these questions and answers, and you can really learn a lot of English from them, okay? And don't be put off by how old it is. A lot of people say they don't want to learn English with anything old because English has changed. English has not changed that much, all right? It wasn't back in Shakespeare's time. So this is still definitely worthwhile watching. And also, the last one we have also has its own YouTube channel. Whose Line Is It Anyway? Now, this is a more modern TV show, and they actually play a lot of games on this TV show. And a lot of them have to do with doing funny little dialogues. So by listening to jokes and by listening to funny made-up dialogues and games where the whole goal of the game is to try to be as funny as possible, this will keep your attention and you'll learn a lot of English at the same time, right? They have to try to act out different expressions, and they have to they're given a topic. Sometimes they're given a topic where they need to suddenly be funny about something, or suddenly talk about something and be and make people laugh. This can give you some good ideas about how to be fluent in English. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. And make sure you click that bell so that you know when I publish a new free lesson here on YouTube. And if you want to learn English with songs, then don't forget to click the link in the description to get my free PDF guide to 101 songs to learn English. I have hundreds of exercises for you to study English, English grammar, English vocabulary, English idioms, practice your English listening, and even your speaking while listening to the very best songs to study English with. All right, and when you get it, then you also get my weekly email with 5 words of the week, where I teach you another 5 words every single week so that you continue to take your English language learning to that next level. All right, my friend, I'm Gabriel Wallace. Keep learning and keep going.